on a beautiful early August night. Hello, Canada. Welcome to the island of Montreal, which has been winning island lately. Three straight wins for the Montreal Alouettes, streaking in the right direction. The Ottawa REDBLACKS have lost four straight.
On the REDBLACKS, hope that the return of this man to their lineup, quarterback Dominique Davis, will help them get things turned around. He has missed the last two, but in his last two starts, Davis, three interceptions versus no touchdown passes. And his counterpart, as you mentioned, Rod, trending in the opposite direction, Vernon Adams Jr., with three consecutive victories, posted over 300 yards passing in a win over Ottawa earlier this season.
Well, they're not getting too excited. According to Kahari Jones, focus on every game and do it with passion as they try to take this streak to four. And for Rick Campbell, the Eastern Division champions last year, four straight losses. They opened the season with two straight wins. The latest loss last week, a walk-off loss against the Calgary Stampeders in the nation's capital. And so they try to right the ship here tonight. Boris Beaty is going to kick this off. REDBLACKS won the toss. They're in white tonight. And they decided to take the football right out of the gate. Away we go from the hill at McGill. Devontae Dedmon has speed, and he's brought down near the 30-yard line. Turn of 22 yards. Dominique Davis is back in the huddle.
Well, you look at Davis's numbers, three touchdowns versus seven interceptions. The interesting quirk about Davis's stats is he has not thrown an interception and a touchdown pass within the same game. It's been kind of all or none. So we'll see which way the trend takes him tonight if it continues.
Davis was banged up. Now he's throwing right away. Comes back into the lineup. It looks like he's got close to a first down. And here is who he'll be throwing to tonight, including Brad Sinopoli.
Yeah, Sinopoli was a little more involved in the Ottawa offense last week in the loss to Calgary. A positive sign, certainly, for the REDBLACKS along the offensive line. Nolan McMillan is the most experienced of a collection of five first-round picks on that starting O-line.
So they'll move the sticks, a running play after the pass to Noel Thomas. Very quick first down in their first series, something that the REDBLACKS haven't been able to do, and considering over the last four or five seasons, they've been doing that, marching up and down the field and winning a lot of ball games. Hand off to John Crockett. Carries the keys to the tailback car. Taylor Loeffler in on that play. Here's the defense for Montreal tonight.
Yeah, keep an eye on Antonio Simmons, the bookend to John Bowman. He's been very active here in his first full Canadian Football League season. In the linebacking core, Patrick Levels has been a terrific addition coming over from Calgary. He leads the defense in defensive plays this season. And Greg Reed, the back end at halfback, leads the way with three picks.
Look out, high snap. But Davis got it and chucked it away. Could have been a disaster. Instead, the worst that will happen is the REDBLACKS will kick it away. High snap. Way over the head of Dominique Davis. Alex Mateus.
Well, and you saw Davis with his center, Mateus, after the play, kind of discussing what went wrong. Of course, Mateus snaps it. He doesn't have a chance to look back and see where it ends up. He's got bigger worries.
Two men back for the Alouettes, including Shakir Ryan in his first game. First touch for Ryan, former BC Lion and Hamilton Tiger Cat, who's got lightning speed, taking over for Marcus Taylor. He's released this week and trying to find a fill-in for Steph Logan, who was released earlier. Vernon Adams is ready to go to work when we come back on Friday Night Football.
Number one irons in golf.
The CFL on TSN is brought to you by the Nissan Titan, official vehicle of the Canadian Football League. The slopes of Mount Royal, McGill University, Percival Molson Stadium. Alouettes back at it. Gorgeous night tonight. Vernon Adams Jr. and his Alouettes, their offense takes the field. Last time they were on this field, 2 weeks ago, coming off a bye week. An impressive win over the Edmonton Eskimos at home. full of confidence right now is this Alouette team, Dwayne.
Yeah, and that's something that they've earned. I think they've done a terrific job fighting through adversity. One of the pieces they were missing last week, receiver B.J. Cunningham back in the lineup, a welcome addition. Along the offensive line, some shuffling with Tyler Johnstone out of the lineup at right tackle. Sean Jameson slides out from guard to tackle. Spencer Wilson, the versatile veteran, plugs in at Jameson's right guard spot.
Passing down here for Adams, second down and 7. Comes the blitz, and he dumps it off to power back William Standback, who slipped up and is going to be shy about 3 yards and a very quick 2 and out for the Alouettes. An auspicious beginning for the Alouettes here.
Yeah, just a quick hitter. You've got to believe that the Alouettes will be looking for different ways to get the ball into the hands of number 31 tonight. He rushed for an even 100 yards against Ottawa in their meeting 3 weeks ago.
Montreal came into tonight with the least amount of 2 and outs in the CFL this season, but quickly, 2 and gone. Deadman makes one miss and then back up near the 30-yard line where Dominic Davis again will bring his offense out in the field. Watch the trends for both of these teams. They both do not score a lot of points in opening quarters. But you know what? That's kind of been a trend throughout the CFL this season, really the last couple of seasons. I'm not sure about the rhyme or reason to it, but it seems like there's a feeling out process. Very cautious beginnings to a lot of CFL games in opening quarters.
Yeah, and you've got to believe, even more so in a year where I think we're as close to parity as we've been in some time. When you look kind of top to bottom in terms of projecting teams' records at the end of the season, and you know, and there may be a couple of extremes right now, but I think when things play out over the course of the season, you're less likely to see the 15 and 3s and the 3 and 15s, maybe a little more like 12-13 wins at the top, 12-13 losses at the bottom, just closing the gap a little bit.
Second down and 10 from the 30. What you're also seeing is some dynamite defense early in ball games. Alouettes rush 3. Davis fires, and it's in and out, and it's picked off. And Ciante Evans has the interception, is brought down. Julian Faoli Godino, and a turnover right away. Ciante Evans has his first pick as an Alouette, and instantly into field position through the gloves of Julian Faoli Godino. Into the midst of Ciante Evans, INTALS. Montreal ball when we come back.
And body.
Julian Faoli Godino, the intended receiver, is running an in route on the play. Ciante Evans, one of 3 DBs dropping to cover their thirds. As that ball gets deflected, thrown a little bit behind the intended receiver, Evans, in covering that deep zone, finds himself in perfect position as it's tipped up in the air.
Yeah, that one will go to Dominic Davis. That's his 8th interception, but a lot of that is also on Faoli Godino.
Yeah, the throw was just a hint behind him, but definitely a catchable ball.
Immediately to the score zone. The red zone inside the 20. Adams looking to make them pay. Will he? Oh, going up high for B.J. Cunningham. A little too high that time as Cunningham returns to the lineup and almost returned to the score sheet.
B.J. Cunningham is the most experienced member of that Montreal Alouettes receiving corps, and his importance becomes amplified in the continued absence of Devier Posey, who's on the 6-game injured list. See Cunningham with that brace on his left knee.
Alouettes now plus 9 turnover ratio. That's best in the Canadian Football League. Adams looks one way, dumping it off. It's Standback down to the 10 and needed to get to the 7-yard line to go first and goal. So Kahari Jones looking at this. Will he bring in the big team or are they going to go for the points? They're going for the points. Boris Beattie coming out to kick a field goal.
And the thing I appreciate on this play We talked about this with getting these two running backs involved. Jeremiah Johnson in the game at the same time as William Standback creates a little bit of a diversion, and that's what the Alouettes are going for here, to try and take some of the keys away from William Standback. Show Johnson with that free release to the flat. Adams gives a look that way to set up and try and open up the screen.
So the best the Owls will do off the turnover is 3 points from Beattie. Basically a chippy 17-yarder. Boris Beattie puts it through. So the interception by Ciante Evans leads to a Beattie field goal. Could have been a lot worse for the Ottawa Redblacks, who now try to dust themselves off after that. Boris Beattie, the veteran kicker from France. Now 11 for 13 on the season, and it's 3-0 Owls.
1783.
Week 8 in the CFL, which has been a close week so far. A couple of thrillers last night. Tomorrow, Battle of Alberta, live mic game. You hear from the quarterbacks, the coaches, and a couple of key defensive players.
Well, I think you might get a chance to hear what it sounds like when a quarterback gets hit with the mics on Almondo Sewell and Cordero Law tomorrow night.
Yes, we will listen in. It's tomorrow to 4-2's Stamps and the Eskimos. How about the games last night going down to the wire? We're in Toronto. Argos finally got off the schneid.
Yeah, what the records say on paper doesn't mean much come game time.
See if the close game trend continues here in Montreal tonight. 3-0 Alouettes, the handoff to Crockett, cutting back and his net head on up to a 45-yard line and a first down again. John Crockett, who averages 5.7 yards a carry, gets more than that for a first down. Former star from North Dakota State.
Yeah, Crockett has been a terrific addition to this Ottawa offense.
Of course, it would be Taylor Loeffler.
Lower in the boom.
Another first and 10. Play action. Davis this time pegs it off to Sinopoli, who fumbled the football. He had it stripped by Taylor Loeffler, who plays pickpocket. What a strip that was.
Well, yeah, there are times when you see a fumble where a guy isn't handling the ball securely or protecting it, and sometimes it's just a real takeaway, and that's the way this one appeared to me. Sinopoli came down with the catch. Watch Loeffler come in. Rip it out of there.
Rip and strip on Sinopoli.
Watch the extra pull with that right hand. And falls conveniently into the Montreal safety's arms.
Another turnover. Now plus 10, the Alouettes on the season. Play action again. Adams on the run. B.J. Cunningham, 62 straight games now with a catch again. Missed 2 weeks ago.
Well, we're going to take a look at the end zone shot of this, and you maybe get a bit of an indication of the vision of Vernon Adams. This is a great timing play and timing throw. As he's throwing this to a spot, as Cunningham is working to that spot, absolutely threading the needle. You saw Randall Evans, the corner, closing from the outside. DeAndre Ferris, the halfback, making that a tight space from the inside.
Should be a free play here for the Alouettes. Stand back. Crashing near the 32-yard line. Going high and then coming up about a 5-yard gain. Looked like the Red Blacks had moved.
Offside. Ottawa number 42. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Dave Foxcroft, our referee tonight. Here in McGill. So it'll be first and 5 now.
Those free agent acquisitions certainly paying off for the Montreal Alouettes defense. Ciante Evans, Taylor Loeffler among them. coming up with big plays early.
Niles went out and loaded up in the offseason with some key free agents. Comes that rush again. Adams. High point ball for Cunningham. Randall Evans make that Eugene Lewis. Geno Lewis can't bring it down, so it'll be second down.
Yeah, high throw. Lewis did a nice job going up to get this one. You see almost a like a rebound effect sort of in that as he's reaching back to get the ball, and as the hands came forward, ended up just batting that ball down.
Lewis had a great start to the season. Has thrown for a touchdown, has everything but scored a touchdown. Far side for Quan Gray, who scored last time these teams met. He just throws the defender, Corey Tindall, to the turf and moves the sticks. Quan Gray.
Yeah, Gray with it, his biggest game in the Canadian Football League. In the last meeting between these two teams, 5 for 134. Bray, this time lined up as the number two receiver coming out of the slot. Two clears in front of him, pulls the defense away, leaves him open in the flat. Bray has that kick returner skill set that makes you want to get the ball in his hands quickly in space.
There was a challenge flag on the field. Rick Campbell throwing the yellow early. He is 0 for 1 on challenges.
Ottawa is challenging that there is offensive pass interference against their defender number 7. We'll review the play.
Chris Randall would be that defender. We'll take a look at it as Command takes a look at it. We'll step aside and return on Friday Night Football on TSN from Montreal. So Chris Randall is the player involved in this challenge from Ottawa head coach Rick Campbell.
Yeah, and we talked on that play about the two clearing routes kind of opening things up for Quan Bray. Chris Randall, the corner on that side, was one of the guys that got pushed off. But to me, I think when you look at the replay, it looks as if Randall is actually fighting to go with one of the receivers going deep as opposed to getting pushed deep by a receiver.
So the verdict is in. Let's go to Dave Foxcroft.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. There was no offensive pass interference on the play. First down, Montreal.
Campbell is 0 for 2 this early season. Challenges. First down. Ray comes to the field side, the near side. Jordan Adams sets things in motion. Hands it off to Standback. Four, likely setting up another throwing down. They could get it down to the 5-yard line and go first and goal, but the Owls, I'm sure, do not want to have to settle for another field goal after another early turnover.
Well, just going back to take a quick look, Rod, at the previous play, and the non-call. Chris Randall is the corner. This actually looks like the last play.
So second and 7. Trying to find pay dirt. Adams forced out. Flushed, rushes down. Like he had the touchdown. What a run and a dive by Vernon Adams, who is slow to get up and in some discomfort on that far sideline.
Well, the heck of an effort from Vernon Adams. You know, it's one of those where as a coach, you're holding your breath a little bit because probably in any other part of the field, you're thinking somewhere along the way here, he might go out of bounds or might slide. But because he's so close to the goal line, he's fighting for that touchdown. I think it was a matter of sort of landing on the combination of the ball and the pylon with a defender on top of him.
And indeed, it was Rod Fernandez. Looks like Vernon is up and is all right. I'd say he's all right.
He was more than all right on that play.
Souvenir for a fan. Apparently just had the wind knocked out of him. Vernon Adams Jr. Fourth rushing touchdown, maybe his most spectacular yet. Laid out for that pylon. The Alouettes again making the Redblacks pay here on turnovers. Field goal off of a fumble and now a touchdown. Field goal off of an interception and now a touchdown off a fumble. Point after by Boris Beattie. No problem. 10-0. Alouettes have the crowd into it. They've got momentum. They seek a fourth straight win. Let's go to the sideline. Patrolling it once again here in Montreal is John Liu.
Well, thank you, Rod. And after that score, it's an opportune time to ask, are the Alouettes favorites or are they underdogs in the wide open East? And the fact of the matter is that they're not really paying attention to those perceptions because in their minds, the team is still trying to forge an identity. It's too early in the process in light of all the turbulent events that started this season that led from the offseason. And so the Alouettes are simply trying to forge an identity for themselves. Players in Kahari Jones saying that it's too early in the discovery process to define what they are. But universally, the one characteristic that players and coaches are pointing to that they do like is that this team does not quit, even in their two losses that open the season, guys.
A little question about that. We had an opportunity to see the Alouettes in week one against the Edmonton Eskimos, a game that looked like it had been decided early. And this team, with particularly when Vernon Adams came off the bench, looked terrific down the stretch. You see Antonio Pipkin beside him, by the way. Pipkin injured in week one, opened the door for Adams. Pipkin had been the opening night starter.
Got pipped.
Pip got pipped.
Devontae Dedman with a spark here. Full throttle. He can fly. Goodbye. Taunting him down the sidelines. And Devontae Dedman with a huge touchdown and a gigantic answer from the Ottawa Redblacks. Dedman did that in the preseason, earned him a job. And this time, 111 yards. And another kick return touchdown from another CFL dynamo.
And you get a great indication right there of the extra gear of Devontae Dedman as he just turned it on to get to the sideline. And Milt Stegall will tell you, you can't let the kicker catch you. And Dedman certainly ran away from Boris Beattie on that one.
They'll go for two. And Brandon Galanders has the two-point convert, and suddenly all of the momentum that Montreal had evaporates quickly. A 111-yard return. Brandon Galanders with a two-point convert, and now it's a two-point ball game. And a red-black team that is now 5 of 7 on two-pointers this season.
A good-looking play on the two-point convert. The man of the moment, however, Devontae Dedman. And, you know, you talk about questions and answers. One of the big questions for this Ottawa team coming into the season, we knew they had receivers to replace in Greg Ellingson and Deontay Spencer in particular. The big thing with Spencer was that he was more than just a big-time receiver for them, but also very important in the return game. Devontae Dedman.
Everybody back home, man. Let's get off.
Providing that kind of special team spark to which this team became accustomed with Deontay Spencer in red and black.
Dedman running down the sideline. star out of William and Mary. Another good kick returner slash receiver slash head coach slash legend.
GM slash president slash running back.
Prime Minister of Canada, Michael Pinball Clemens.
Yes, sir.
Out of William and Mary, who must be smiling. Well, wait a second. He smiles all the time. Ryder Stone, nice return. It's been the year of the return so far in the Canadian Football League, and Deadman adds.
Available intelligent around view monitor and standard rear cross traffic alert. Don't settle for less than the Nissan Rogue.
Vontae Deadman did that preseason game in Ottawa when he earned that job. He was wearing number 79 that day, kind of a lineman number.
Yeah, we talked a little bit at the time about getting away from those numbers that you get assigned in training camp and they make you wonder how good your odds of making the team are.
Stand back. Plows through. Moves the chains. 13-yard pickup.
Oh, Williams, stand back. Named one of the CFL's performers of the month for July. We mentioned the 100-yard performance against Ottawa. Also posted that 200-yard game and win over Hamilton.
Lots of offense, special teams early on. Adams dishing it off to Bray. Gets a nice block. Quan Bray close to another first down.
Interesting collection of young players assembled here. Interesting and exciting, quite frankly, in Montreal. I know for Kahari Jones, when general manager Kavis Reed was let go, one of Kahari Jones' messages to him was, aside from thanking him for the opportunity to coach the team, thank you for the team that you put together for me, because he likes this group he's got, and they have rewarded his faith.
Second down and two. Stand back again. Nice hurdle. Williams, stand back, adds to the highlight reel. Stand back again. Guy averages 5.7 yards a carry, but way over that average right now, averaging 100 yards a game.
Alouettes did a nice job there, going double tight end, flattening out the line, stretching things out, taking away the second level. As you see the rushing yards per game this season. Four carries for 40 yards for him thus far tonight.
The Lightning is in now. Jeremiah Johnson, part of that Thunder and Lightning backfield. 5-yard pickup.
And again, Jeremiah Johnson, very good running back in his own right, a guy who's been around this league, started off with Toronto, spent some time in Ottawa before spending the last couple years as a BC Lion. But in joining these Alouettes, it's not just a depth move, but, you know, as I alluded to earlier in this game, as teams start to key on William Standback, it's great to have a guy like Jeremiah Johnson, whether you're spelling stand back there to keep him fresh, or whether you're getting the two of them on the field at the same time.
Number two, first quarter. Adams again. Malcolm Carter has his first CFL catch. Has been targeted once this season. Former Carlton Raven and Ottawa Sooner, Malcolm Carter. You are on the board.
Yeah, Malcolm Carter, drafted a couple years ago by the Alouettes. As you mentioned, started his career, college career in Ottawa at Carleton University. Ended up leaving school, went to play junior with the Ottawa Sooners. Was the top offensive player in Ontario junior football.
Adams, one way then the other for Stanback. Again, looks like they're close to another first down. They could reset, go first and goal. A minute to go in this opening quarter that's had a little bit of everything here tonight. Adams being so poised right now and confident in that pocket.
And just week by week, it seems that that confidence grows. Again, Vernon Adams looking very much like the guy Canadian Football League fans thought they were getting, that the Montreal Alouettes, in fact, thought they were getting when they traded for his negotiation list rights with BC.
Deep drop, Adams again. Eugene Lewis, touchdown number one, and a little posing in the end zone. Why wouldn't you? There's one for the souvenir case.
Yes, sir.
Threw one 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, Vernon Adams Jr. reciprocating here against the Ottawa Redblacks. Lewis threw the touchdown pass to him a couple weeks ago. A little razzle-dazzle play. This time it's Adams to Lewis for the major.
Now, did his knee go down? They're looking at that at command.
Yeah.
Just reviewing that.
I think that knee may well be down before the ball breaks the plane of the goal line.
Yeah, that celebration may be a little premature in the end zone. They may have to line up once more. We'll find out. They're reviewing it. Every scoring play is reviewed. It looked like that knee was down just the ball. The nose of the ball.
The previous scoring play is under review by the command center.
Has to break the plane of the goal line. And this might take away Eugene Lewis's first CFL touchdown.
We'll take another peek here.
I think he's down.
See, because the knee is down before he has a chance to reach.
I think they're going to give them the first down, and they'll go first and goal.
Yeah, and this is our best look right down the goal line. So there,
his
knee is down, and you can see he's well short of in slow motion terms, well short of the goal line.
So, verdict is in. Will they reset?
After review, the ball carrier's knee was down short of the goal line. It'll be first down, Montreal, from the 1 yard line.
So first and goal, taking away that souvenir football.
Yeah, so presumably he will give the ball back and Vernon Adams Jr. will still owe him one.
Yeah, or maybe you call a running play here. Or a little passing play. Vernon Adams Jr., the 26-year-old Californian, came to the CFL with so much promise and hype, and it's taken a bit. BC to Montreal.
And, you know, we talk all the time in this league about how it takes quarterbacks time to develop. It's been a circuitous path for Adams, but he's certainly finding his way here in 2019.
Adams trying to pull in, goes in backwards. They're giving him the touchdown. So now Vernon Adams has two touchdowns tonight. And now they're going to redo the photo. See, that other one was photoshopped. And now
Though the key for Adams, though, he's pushing for the whole team to celebrate together, which, you know, some people say whatever they want to say about the celebrations, but he's guiding, leading the way, saying we scored as a team, let's celebrate as a team.
And this is a score as a team. A scrum that...
Yeah, 12 men pushing in the same direction.
Carries that ball over. So the touchdown taken away from Eugene Lewis. It's an interesting formation. And then Adams has his second major of the night. Alouettes respond to that kickoff return touchdown. Flummoxed Rick Campbell.
Now there you see it, 8 plays strung together by the Alouettes.
It's the 4th rushing touchdown in 5 quarters against Ottawa this year for Vernon Adams Jr. Sweeney. Point after. A lot of interesting stuff on that whole drive. Mishmash, balance of plays, and that's something, frankly, we haven't seen from the Montreal Alouettes in years. That kind of positive momentum, that kind of spark. And a lead early on here. First quarter, thanks to Vernon Adams and the Montreal Alouettes.
Catch up anytime on CTV.ca.
Well, the Montreal Alouettes gave up a touchdown for the first time in the first quarter this season on that long kickoff return. Vernon Adams, though, the story so far, 8 of 10 so far. You can see the passing numbers. Just 69 yards, but key 69 yards. And, of course, he does it with his feet. And speaking with Vernon Adams the last two times we've been in Montreal, talks about how, you know, the expectation and pressure is there, Dwayne, but he's saying he's having so much fun. And you can see that from the Alouettes right now.
Yeah, you certainly can. And they're taking their cues from their head coach, and no one more than Vernon Adams, who's having the opportunity to learn from an experienced Canadian Football League quarterback, a guy who's been through what he's been through, who has seen the things that he's seeing, and able to impart some of that, not just knowledge, but a mindset as well. Adams playing with so much confidence.
Here goes Deadman once more. Follows a block. Another pretty decent return. Not the distance this time, but a good starting point for Dominic Davis. Time of possession has been a factor for the Ottawa Redblacks. You can see it's been diminishing week in and week out. They are dead last, 26 minutes per game. Time of possession. Rick Campbell yesterday said, simply put, we got to get our offense and keep it on the field a little more.
Yeah, and that's going to be huge here. If you saw those numbers at the end of the first quarter, Montreal only allowed Ottawa to have the football for 3 minutes and 39 seconds of the opening 15.
That's what Davis can do, run that football. Now he's going to tuck it, take it, and saunter out of bounds.
Now you think that Ottawa defense kept on the field for 11 minutes and 21 seconds. Of the first quarter.
Wow.
If you get that trend continuing, and obviously it's going to be tough for anyone to have the ball that much in a game, but in terms of being dominated in time of possession, imagine the combination now of a fairly fresh William Standback and a fresh Jeremiah Johnson running the football as this game progresses due to that time of possession disparity.
Davis trying to get a first down. Rush coming from the edge, and low toss for Dominic Rimes. Two and outs won't do it. And you also think about an Ottawa defense that does not have a lot of reserves in the lineup tonight.
Yeah, the roster that's been hit a little bit by injuries among the absentees. Of course, Antoine Pruneau, veteran safety.
Richie Leone, leading punter in the Canadian Football League, averaging almost 52 yards. But Shakir Ryan, in his third CFL game, electrifying returner. Makes one miss, makes another, and was tripped up. Otherwise, that could have been a long gainer as well. Alouettes seeking a return threat, and Shakir Ryan just might be that guy. Andre Montgomery with the shoestring tackle.
A young defender and special teamer. Montgomery is going to see some reps at free safety tonight. We mentioned the absence of Antoine Pruneau. They can juggle the ratio a little bit, plugging in the Canadians and the defensive line to free up that safety spot to play the American.
First series, quarter two, hit screen, Quan Gray in stride. Andre Ferris tackles him, former West Kentucky Hilltopper.
Second down, 4 yards to go.
Nice job by Ferris against a shifty receiver. Get up tight on him. Don't allow Quan Bray, the speedster, chance to get moving.
Guy who spent time in the National Football League. Quan Bray, number four, did with Indianapolis, Buffalo, and Houston. Now an Alouette. Second and four. Adams once more. A nice swat down at the line of scrimmage. Mike Wakefield got that big paw on it. And he'll bring out the Montreal kick team. Vernon had thrown six straight. Stops that streak. And so the Red Blacks defense, this time a short stint on the field. 17-8 ball game. Deadman is back near his 20. No breeze here tonight. Cloudless sky. Twilight setting in. Deadman spun to the turf. 27 on a 49-yard boot. 9-point game. Dominic Davis. That's his offense on the field thanks to a key defensive play. Mike Wakefield. Get that garbage out.
Only at Burger King.
I just want to take a look back to something Montreal did offensively that I really liked. Mixing up their snap counts and their motion to try and draw the offside. But if you watch the halfback at the bottom, Corey Tindall, he's trying to time up his blitz to the snap count. Montreal kind of shows that motion to get them to move. Well, now you've got the defense to declare. Now when you wind it back and you run the play, you know exactly what's coming. You know that that weak side halfback blitz is coming. You know exactly what look they're going to give you, what coverage you're going to get, etc., to be prepared for the second play. The knockdown from Mike Wakefield prevented anything from happening. But still a good strategy.
John Crockett. Major weapons this year for the Ottawa Red Blacks, who lost William Powell in the offseason. In fact, they lost a lot of players, key components, but have plugged and played. Crockett has been a force. Has yet to score a touchdown. Dominic Davis. It's two completions so far. Make it three. Far side. J.C. Boyeu, the fullback, hauls it in and will get a first down.
And Ottawa looking to settle things down. Control the clock a little bit, get that defense a break here in the second quarter. Let Dominic Davis get try and find some kind of rhythm, maybe with some quick hitters here, having not played in the last couple of games.
Not played, and rather a daunting start. Comes into the ball game, throws a pick, and now we've got tempers. And shots thrown, but again, you're wearing a lot of equipment and helmets. And now a headbutt there. Chris Aki. Went at one of the linemen.
Aki, who finished last season as an Ottawa Red Black after being traded from Montreal late in the season, played out his option with Ottawa, returned to Montreal as a free agent just after the start of this 2019 season.
Some anger here in this kind of rivalry that we've been waiting to start for the last few years. The Alouettes, though, haven't been very good, haven't really been contenders in the East. Red Blacks have dominated with Hamilton, Toronto a couple years ago. Alouettes have been left in the dust. Giving themselves a fighting chance now.
We'll see where the flags leave things here.
Looks
we
to
have
make
unnecessary roughness,
Montreal.
Number 58 and 64, Ottawa. And we have two unnecessary roughness penalties against number 21, Montreal. It will be second down.
Both against Chris Aki.
Yeah, Aki was in the middle of it and kind of got pulled out of the pile and then waded back in.
I don't know how this will shake down. There were a lot of grill pulling on the cages. A couple of shots. See how the discipline department at the CFL handles that. But yeah, it's on now between these two cities, separated by about 200K. Down to 417. Davis now trying to get some rhythm. And oh, nice catch. Dominic Rhymes. Little juggling act on the far side for Dom Rhymes from Dom Davis.
Yes. And a terrific catch here as the DB Reed flashes in front of it. Oops. Nice concentration there from Mr. Rhymes to stay with the ball.
Furthest the Red Blacks offense have penetrated so far. And that needed to be another juggler. Oh. Not caught, though, by Boyeux.
And Taylor Loeffler adding insult to injury there, maybe adding injury to insult, lowering the boom on the fullback after the drop ball.
He wears that war paint, quite honestly, doesn't he? This warrior, watch this. You got to keep your noggin up out there. Loeffler will take it off. Davis. That was almost picked.
Oh, Chris Ackey. Channeling his anger for more positive gains to snuff out that Ottawa drive.
So now Ottawa brings out Richie Leone. They're not going for a field goal here. It would have been about a 53-yarder. Lewis Ward has that streak of 64 straight. Stad Leone, who has not hunted the ball within the 10-yard line this season. Will he this time? Might have just there. Let's see what the official says. Will this be inside the 10-yard line? Nope, just outside. Pretty good kick, long field for the Alouettes when we come back. Montreal leading 17-8. The hitman is at it tonight. Taylor Loeffler, all-star. Chris Ackey at it as well. Tempers tight on Friday Night Football.
Canada, only on TSN.
Just when you need a little ice in summer, the World Junior Summer Showcase continues tomorrow. World's top under 20 prospects head-to-head, and teams look to cement their rosters ahead of the 2020 World Junior Championship this December. U.S. and Canada battle at 4 Eastern, 1 Pacific, only on TSN. Great night to be at Percival Molson Stadium. The vibe is back here in Montreal in a big way, and thanks to this resurgent Alouette team leading early on here tonight. That's a high toss, errant toss from Vernon Adams.
Well, you're absolutely right about the crowd here, Rodwin. You give them something to cheer about at Molson Stadium. It is one of the most electric atmospheres in the Canadian Football League.
You could smell it sometimes, couldn't you?
Well, yeah, you could. Yeah, now it's legal to smell it, right?
Yes, it is. Friday Night Lights here tonight. Great city of Montreal. Team that's had a lot of adversity away from the field. Ownership situation, GM, head coach. They're winning. Eugene Lewis. He's a guy who's faced a lot of adversity in his time. He's come up catching footballs.
Eugene Lewis on the outside here. Second full year as a starter.
Former Sooner out of Oklahoma, also played with the Nittany Lions at Penn State.
Yeah, started off as at Penn State.
Great basketball player. Oh, look at this. Stand back. monster mash McCann. He has developed into a big name power back.
Well, he's really is that frightening combination, though, as you, you know, you kind of brace yourself for the big hit and then get caught off guard when he runs by you, because this is, guy's got some wheels too.
The size of those pipes. Second and one, they decide to throw. Maybe a bad idea. Adams, though, chucking it away. Vernon Adams. Play kind of to kill. They'll likely bring out the large team here and go for it on third and one, but REDBLACKS read it perfectly.
They sure did. Almost got the Alouettes in a world of trouble here. Adams, you know, it doesn't turn into a spectacular play, but that might be one of Vernon Adams' best escapes. And it's going to be Boris Beattie and the punt team.
They're not going for it.
Well, I'll tell you what, the field position here made me question a little bit how much of a play to burn it really was on second down. You know, it's one thing when you're closer to midfield or in opposition territory to take a shot on second and short, but you know, at your own 35-yard line, I don't know if you're really going to gamble if you get to third and one.
Well, they'll have to cover here because Dedmon is back. This one's angled by Beattie. Nice punt. The bounce in front of Devontae Dedmon. No yards. He zigs and zags, and then near the 40-yard line, they'll likely take the return. That would have been a 5-yard penalty, so they'll start near their 40-yard line. Dominic Davis back. Team down 9. Friday night football rolls on from the Hill at McGill.
Available on iHeartRadio.
Well, Rick Campbell has had a lot of success with the Ottawa REDBLACKS. Been with them since the expansion days. There are a lot of head scratching going on this week after the decision last week to take a safety and basically set up a game winner for the Calgary Stampeders. Not the magic touch last week for Rick Campbell. And with more on that decision from last week, let's go down to John Liu.
Well, thank you, Rod. And when we spoke to Rick Campbell yesterday, he said that after assessing what had happened after his decision to concede a safety instead of punting the ball deep from his own zone that led to their REDBLACKS loss to Calgary, he said that he, in retrospect, he would have punted, would have elected to punt. But what's significant about the decision is that after the game, any REDBLACKS player that was asked about the decision was fully behind their head coach. And that really speaks to the unity and the loyalty within the Ottawa ranks, even though this team is mired in the second longest losing streak in franchise history, guys.
Yeah, it's not a long history, mind you, but yeah, it goes back to that first year. But Rick Campbell, he is the ultimate player's coach.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, with the history of Rick Campbell, I'm going to go with Rick Campbell's gut, even if the book says something different.
Davis and another high snap from Mateus. Enoch Mwamba, Patrick Levels supplying the finishing touch. I mean, again, you know, the questions abound over that decision last week, and I think a lot of people, hey. But if they end up winning the game, hindsight is 2020.
Yeah, and again, playing the numbers, yeah, you're going to make a team have to score a touchdown to beat you rather than give them a chance to beat you with a field goal. Tougher to get a touchdown, especially when you haven't allowed one all night. But, you know, again, Rick Campbell's been at this a long time, and maybe his...
should have gone outside instead of inside there, but this is what Shakir Ryan can do. He did it with Hamilton last year, his first game. Of course, the Cats have so many returners, and Shakir Ryan finds himself back in the CFL, and he might find a city to stay in now.
Well, lightning speed, had a 100-plus yard return for a touchdown, but he... tell you, it looked like he had room to go outside. There's nobody outside Richie Leone, and it didn't appear to me as maybe a face mask at the end of that play, but Leone, to me, didn't have outside leverage to force him in.
comes. It's another high toss, looking for the high point catch with B.J. Cunningham. Most of Vernon Adams' misses tonight have been over the receivers, and one of the luxuries he has is he has some jumping jacks out there.
Well, he certainly does. Look at guys like Geno Lewis. B.J. Cunningham right there. Struggling a little bit with footing. You know, when we were down on the field before the game, and there...
We were struggling with our footing.
Yeah. Well, there's some areas down there where there are some seams that make me a little nervous. Yes. On that field. And some of those areas, what you get is an overabundance of the rubber pellets that are part of this type of surface. And it becomes slippery.
Lewis. Spectacular catch, but out of bounds. The former basketball star, son of a former basketball star as well.
Yeah, he doesn't get credit for the reception or the receiving yards, but there should be, maybe if there were style points in football.
Artistic impression,
yes,
for sure.
He'd be awarded a high score even by the Russian judge on that one.
Yes, he would. So, third down and 10. Devontae Dedmon. Only scoring play so far tonight for the Redblacks has been from that return, 111 yards. Hangs that. Dedmon. Devontae Dedmon is just rocked by J.S. Blanc. John Samuel Blanc. Almost put Dedmon into next week.
Yeah, former Montreal Canadiens star.
Oh.
Oh,
baby.
Love it.
That is a good, clean hit.
Blanc, terrific pass rusher. His Canadiens days has turned himself into a very good special teamer in the CFL.
Crockett scrambling for a couple yards. That's one of the great things I'm sure you admire of being in this great province is the love of football, the youth groups, the young ages, to the university ranks. And,
yeah.
You know, there are great universities around Canada, great football programs, but it's hard to rival what they've done in Quebec.
Yeah,
and
Montreal. Absolutely outstanding. And you look at the programs perennially near the top of the rankings.
Davis, strong arm, too strong.
Your perennial contenders, you know, it seems like there are about six or eight schools that are always in the mix, and Laval and Montreal consistently among them. Laval, of course, the reigning Vanier Cup champions, much to the chagrin of us Western fans.
You got one in there, too, though.
Yeah, 2017.
Yes.
My beloved Mustangs. U Sports training camps.
Starting to open
many
up.
Many opening up next week. Yeah.
Love this time of year. Let's get back to school. Universities start up. U Sport football around the corner. Biggest pipeline to the Canadian Football League. Here's Ryan again. Shakir Ryan. Also hit hard. Nigel Womack. Special teams tackle for the Ottawa Redblacks. Womack with his seventh special teams tackle of the season, native of Thunder Bay. He played in the Atlantic Division in U Sport, St. Mary's.
Yeah, leading special teams tackler for the Redblacks. We talked a little bit last week about Womack as one of the handful of remaining original Redblacks from that inaugural 2014 season.
Seems so long ago. Getting close to the 3-minute warning. Double tight end set. Operate with Standback once more. William Standback quickly making a name for himself. Keep in mind, the last couple of years, in particular last year, was the guy in the wings, Terrell Sutton here, Brandon Rutley. They're no longer here. It's now William Standback's time and Jeremiah Johnson. It's time for the 3-minute warning before halftime. The Alouettes leading 17-8 in Montreal.
Rod and the boys back in the studio getting set for REM at the half. We'll talk about Vernon Adams, William Standback still rolling for Montreal and how those early turnovers have made life that much tougher for Dominic Davis and the Red Blacks offense. Also talk about Stampeders Eskimos tomorrow. Back to Rod and Wayne.
All right, thank you, boys. Looking forward to seeing you in a few minutes. Alouettes, Standback, backfield with Adams. Second down and four. Will he get the ball again here? Receivers in motion. Yes, he does. Standback this time. Pounds. And it'll be another third down.
Yeah, he's going to be short by about a yard, I think.
The last time in this almost exact field position, they punted. Vernon Adams is showing it. No. I mean, he's gone fishing before.
Well, and you know, it's splitting hairs, but the fact is the last time when they punted, it was what we would call a long yard.
Yeah.
You know, I'd say just over a yard. This is maybe just under a yard that they need for the first down.
To get to about the 35.5 yard line. There's that formation again. Cluster. Oh, and Adams has stood up. That second effort caught him the first down initially. Looked like he was stuffed. Think about that third down play. The most successful quarterbacks we've seen in the past get low.
Mm-hmm. Get behind your big boys on that offensive line.
Adams, and this is the thing. Low early.
Yeah, it can't just be the quarterback getting low, but that offensive line has got to get low as well. And it looked like the defense got underneath them a little bit initially here.
To play with the clock, trying to get a couple of first downs, moving into scoring position for the Red Blacks, looking for a stop over the top for Cunningham. Hernandez there on a tackle, tag team tackle, looks like a gain of almost 8 yards, almost 9 as a matter of fact. Jay Cunningham, Michigan State Spartan, Dolphin draft pick. Fifth season with the Alouettes. I'm a feature receiver. Stand back on second and two, automatic. The timing could not have been better for this guy last year when you think about it. Get a chance to play, get some reps, and stick around as the Alouettes rid themselves of their previous two running backs.
And Standback was one of those guys that, quite frankly, it was going to be impossible to keep him off the field. You had to find a way to get him on the field, and that meant trading away a very good football player in Terrell Sutton.
Adams, Jeremiah Johnson in this time. Johnson, a very good player, too. Jumping around, flag down. Flag on that far side, down near the 45-yard line. Johnson barely got a yard, may have even lost a little. Flag down. A minute 35 to go before halftime. Game that saw the Red Blacks turn the ball over twice in the first quarter.
Montreal number 66. 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
10 of their points on the board because of Ottawa turnovers, but the Red Blacks have really settled in now.
Yeah, they certainly have, and obviously given a little bit of breathing room for the fact that they haven't been able to muster a lot offensively, but that kick return by Devontae Dedmon, special teams helping pick up some of the slack here.
Dedmon gave them life, and now first and 20. And Adams goes running. Terry Latanzio, Avery Williams tackle, and now long second down. If Red Blacks play this right, they could get the ball back and try to score before the half.
Quarterback draw, they're trying to lure that pass rush upfield and let the defender's momentum take them, push them in the lanes. A good reaction from the Red Blacks there to shut her down.
Second down and 13. Stand back in the backfield, stays into block. Adams, and trying to lunge edge out is Bray. Blanket coverage from Randall on that far side, and so indeed, Red Blacks will get the ball back and a chance to drive it upfield. Put themselves in scoring position. Vernon Adams flatlining two of his last eight. It was 9 for 11 out of the chute. Deadman back at his 10. And again, Beatty. Likely will try to angle this. Goes to the near hash. Bounces once, no yards. There goes Deadman again. Stays on his feet. Devontae Deadman still on his feet. No way! Are you kidding me? Fun race now. Deadman down the sideline. An amazing return by Devontae Deadman.
In the words of Milton Steele,
did he do that?
Oh my
goodness! The flag is no yards. This touchdown will count. Devontae Deadman with one of the most spectacular returns you will ever see.
The penalties declined. Touchdowns.
The Devontae Deadman show continues.
Now his fellow William & Mary alum that we compared him to earlier had a nickname.
Pinball.
And it seemed kind of appropriate here. Bounces off one, keeps his balance. Ducks under another, keeps his balance, gets drilled, keeps his balance, spins, keeps his balance, gets tripped, keeps his balance, and then just outruns the last one.
It's pinball two. Devontae Deadman, star from William & Mary, star tonight for the Ottawa Redblacks. Well, in the year of special teams, the year of the kick return continues.
Yeah, this is it. We got a note earlier from CFL statistician extraordinaire Steve Daniel.
Pace for a record year. Dominic Davis for two. Big stop. Tommy Campbell, but still. Alouettes stopped the two-point convert, but they can't stop Devontae Deadman tonight.
Oh, they sure can.
Deadman running.
So his kickoff return was the seventh kickoff return touchdown this season. That ties a single season high set in 03 and 94. And only 30 games.
Devontae Deadman tonight has become the first Ottawa player in franchise history, from the Rough Riders to the Red Blacks, the Renegades, to ever score two returns on kicks in Ottawa franchise history. Never happened before till tonight. 111 yards on a kickoff return. 95 yards on the punt return. And guess what? He may not be done yet. The spirit of Pinball Clemens.
Whole half of football to go.
That was nuts. That was a crazy return.
Yeah, impressive.
And again, a silencer here in this stadium is pumping up the volume.
Go!
Shakir Ryan trying to join the show. So that is now another kick return touchdown this season. On pace for over 30 right now.
Yeah,
15 last year in 2018.
If I'm a CFL special teams coordinator,
yes,
I am asking for a raise.
In many ways.
Yes.
For both ways. You know what I'm saying? That can be a job full of victory and glory and agony.
Yeah. Those guys are not getting a whole lot of sleep right now.
Both of these teams have not surrendered a kick return for a touchdown or scored this season a kick return for a touchdown. And so Devontae Deadman, becomes another footnote in CFL history. 20th time
But a player has returned two kicks. There's Bob Dice. Bob is only 18 years old.
Yes, the stress of the job, it's taken its toll.
But that's what can happen. 20th time that a player has returned two kicks in a game. No one has ever returned three.
No one ever.
That could happen tonight, the way that guy's running. That is off the charts. Thank goodness for the Ottawa return team tonight. It's kept them in this ball game.
Yeah, very much overshadowing the fact that the offense hasn't mustered a point for the Red Blacks thus far.
85 net yards of offense.
And Deadman?
200 yards, 111 and 95.
Well, and his total return yards, 300 on the game. Oh. Offense, 85. Deadman, 300.
So Deadman probably is a little exhausted right now.
Run.
There he is out there, but Nate Behar is also out there. And Chris Randall picks up the football with 4 seconds to go. 3-point game because of Deadman, who has been deadly, lethal weapon.
This is it. Ottawa fans, you've got less than 100 yards of total offense. You haven't been the beneficiary of any turnovers, so how are you only trailing by 3 points?
Devontae Deadman.
Yeah, special teams, that return game. Led by Devontae Deadman, getting her done.
Red Blacks will take a knee. Devontae Deadman will go get some oxygen. May not be done yet. Stand by.
Let's go!
We got to have a heck of a second half coming. The first half had a little bit of everything. Devontae Deadman, a whole lot of him. A lot of Vernon Adams and the Alouettes, and it's a 3-point game on Friday Night Football. Rod Smith, catch your breath. Back to you.
It's Friday Night Football, yeah!
Now Vernon Adams has two touchdowns tonight. An amazing return by Devontae Deadman. It has been the Devontae Deadman hour for the first half of Friday Night Football. A pair of return touchdowns, a 111-yard kick return, 95-yard punt return. Double D is with John Liu.
Devontae, because your team has been vulnerable to big plays that have led to losses in this stretch, were your two kick return touchdowns more than just points on the board, but morale boosters as well?
I just try to do what I can to help the team win. The coaches put us in great situations, and I just try to make the best of the opportunity.
Prior to coming to the CFL, when was the last time you had a recurring game of this magnitude at any level of ball?
Maybe youth football, back when I was like 8 or 9. But I'm just happy to be here with the team and just try to make the best of this opportunity. Just help the team win.
Should we start calling you Speedy D?
Just call me by my real name, Devontae. That's all I can say.
Hey, thanks for this, Devontae.
Thank you.
Devontae Deadly, as he has been incredible tonight. 300 kick return yards. Most kick return yards recorded by Larry Taylor, who was a former Al, was with Calgary.
Yeah, 2012 against the Toronto Argonauts.
Shakir Ryan, hot-collared by Justin Howell.
Deontay Spencer, by the way, holds the Ottawa Redblacks record for most return yards in a game.
We shall see how it plays out here tonight.
Yes, that may be within reach.
You'd have to think that the Alouettes went into the locker room thinking, okay, we're going to find a way to stop this guy, and they might be kicking away from him a lot more tonight. But Vernon Adams with a 3-point lead. First series, second half. Seen a lot of Williams stand back. I heard the guys in the studio talking about the importance of stand back in the lineup. There's a flag down on the first play from scrimmage here in this second half.
holding Montreal number 51. 10-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
And if you're just joining us, missed a lot in the first half. Two turnovers by the Redblacks resulted in points by the Owls. Interception led to a field goal. Fumble return led to another a touchdown. It was 10-0 early. Then this guy went to work.
Yes, sir. Devontae Dedmon, a kickoff return for a touchdown, followed it up with a punt return for a touchdown.
Four receivers to the right for Adams with good protection. And a bad toss for Eugene Lewis. Wide open on a crossing pattern.
And after a pretty good start, this Montreal offense, particularly in the passing game, has been a little out of sync.
A lot of high tosses from Adams. How stagnant this offense has become. Going off to a great start here tonight. Trying to make it four straight wins. Redblacks have lost four in a row. An uncharacteristic of this team over the last few seasons. Four-man rush. Vernon Adams on second and 20. Oh, it's picked off! How about that? And again, Mike Wakefield in the middle of it. Noel Thorpe erupts.
Well, we saw Wakefield with a knockdown in the first half. This time he's able to squeeze it. A rather massive turnover created by the big Ottawa defensive tackle.
Reels it in. First turnover of the night for the Redblacks.
Keep an eye here. The Montreal offensive line does a nice job blocking it up, but low throw. And
gets a knockdown and a pick.
Yeah, soft hands for the big fella. He's lobbying for a short yardage passing play to him.
Redblacks have a chance to take their first lead. Crockett. Chris Ackie says no way. Set up second down. This is the first time tonight the Ottawa offense has been in the red zone inside the 20.
Now watch the pursuit. Chris Ackie bursting out of the box. Make the play from his weak side linebacker position.
Second down and goal. Davis, touchdown, Brad Sinopoli. Back-to-back weeks. Sinopoli has his second of the season, and the assist, a huge one from that huge guy.
Yes, sir, Mike Wakefield sets the table for the Ottawa offense.
Redblacks have their first lead.
Brad Sinopoli is going to come in motion left to right on your screen, slips out to the flat, and just gets lost in traffic coming from behind that line. Quick hitter from Dominique Davis, and going back to the start of the game, this is the first time this season now that Dominique Davis has thrown a touchdown pass and an interception in the same game.
Lewis Ward, dependable kicker, point after. Now a four-point lead, Redblacks. Turnovers played a part in this one tonight. Mike Wakefield's pick leads to the touchdown by Brad Sinopoli. And the Redblacks surge in front.
Here's to craftier thinking.
Well, we've got a wild one cooking here tonight. Rivals out in the east. Ottawa Redblacks take their first lead thanks to Mike Wakefield. Vernon Adams, first turnover of the night. Worst possible position on the field. Had a night of kick return sensations. Shakir Ryan near the 30-yard line. Vernon Adams trying to regroup and trying to recapture the lead.
Well, and this is an interesting little test for Vernon Adams, as it's been, you know, 3 weeks of positive, really, for the Alouettes quarterback. You see the numbers at the bottom of the screen. His first 11 passes, completed 9 of them. His last 11, he's completed just 2 of them. And so now facing a little bit of adversity after being on a pretty good roll the last few weeks. Let's see how he responds here in the second half.
6-2 as a starter. There's that pitch pass. Gene Lewis. Stop near the line of scrimmage. That was thrown behind him. Gene Lewis, who also threw last week, back to Vernon Adams, could have possibly thrown there, but won't. 2nd and 8 now.
Second career touchdown pass for Eugene Lewis, threw one last season as well. Former quarterback, high school quarterback. Mm-hmm. Became a receiver at Penn State.
Change this play. Montreal won for their last 7 on 2nd down. This time, Jake Kleinicke converts. Up near the 52, his first catch of the night.
That's a big-time throw and catch. Kleinicke has been, in terms of points per catch, one of the most productive receivers in the league. Came into this game with just 6 catches on the season, but 3 of those had gone for touchdowns.
1st and 10 from the 52. Stand back again. They like to work him to that A gap, and then Adams likes to throw that fake pass after, and this is a flag that was thrown after initial contact. Late hit, Gerard Fernandez. Works as the middle linebacker tonight in this Ottawa D. Likely flagged on this play.
Major foul, face mask, Ottawa number 35. Premier Essay, Montreal.
Look at Dave Foxcroft rocking the French.
Hey? Call David. Pretty blatant.
Blatant and not the smartest play.
Not really sure how Fernandez expected to get away with that one.
Not sure. 1st and 10 at the Ottawa 40. The Red Black defense has really settled in after a slow start, but William Standback goes high, hurdling again. What about this guy? Big body, powerful guy, but he can fly too.
Yeah, and this is what I was saying about you anticipate as a defender with a guy who's a power runner like Standback. You've got to get low and you've got to take him at the legs. So defender comes up to do that, Chris Randall. And he goes, shows you the athleticism and goes over you.
2nd and inches, and again, Adams stood up, but 2nd effort. Standback tonight, by the way, averaging 8 yards a carry. 10 carries, 80 yards. Close to another 100-yard game, right at his average. What a revelation he has been this year for the Alouettes in those new-look uniforms. New logo, new look. That's renewed good. Success.
Yeah, definitely a new vibe here in Montreal.
1st and 10 now. Play action. Adams going deep. Jump ball. These guys are amping for a little celebration time on top celebrations of the week. What do you think?
Yeah, this young team bringing all kinds of excitement to Montreal. And this was one that I know I was holding my breath a little bit when Vernon Adams put this ball up in the air. Juan Bray boxes out the defender, Anthony Chaffee. Goes up and gets it. Did he hold on?
Did he hold on?
Scoring play will be automatically reviewed.
And that's what they're doing right now. Let's take a look. Did? I think he had that gloved hand underneath, but it's command right now. That is a ridiculous catch.
The play is under review by the command center.
Yeah, the question is whether you want to call that conclusive, because to me that felt like a trap.
Yeah,
it looked like with the bottom point of that ball sticking out, like that hit the ground as he came down.
Again, it might be another celebration that is wasted here tonight, and I think you may be right. From that replay, the one we saw earlier, this is probably the best look right here.
Yeah. He's got an arm.
Can't trap it.
Around the ball.
With the ground.
But there's so much of the ball exposed there.
But there's fingers underneath the ball. Oh, man.
Yeah, and this is why I say it's a question of what you want to call conclusive. Because to me, there's such a percentage of the ball touching the turf behind where his fingers are. Like, yeah, his fingers are under part of it. So I will leave this.
Yeah, I could see where there is some question. This is why this review is taking so long. The fact that it is taking this long might signal that it's not a touchdown. Juan Bray, who scored his lone CFL touchdown a few weeks ago down the road in Ottawa. Monster night. Here it is. The jury has reached its decision.
After review, the ruling on the field is overturned. It's an incomplete pass.
Yep.
It'll be second down, Montreal, from the 29-yard line.
Video review has been so good for the Canadian Football League. Alouettes are hating video review right now. Because that would have been a touchdown.
Yeah, I think.
And I think they got it right.
Yeah, I hate to take a highlight off the board.
Yeah.
But I think it's the right call.
It has been a night of highlights. That would have been just another addition to it. The second and 10. Now, Owls were denied a touchdown earlier, stopped at the goal line. Then they did celebrate again after that. Will they double dip again? Movement. And it was Ottawa. It looks like now Ottawa's pointing at Montreal. A lot of finger pointing going on here. Michael Claussen, former Al. You did it. No, you did it. No, you did it. No, you did it.
Offside.
Who did it?
Ottawa, number 94. 5-yard penalty remains second down.
Changes things considerably.
There's Mike Claussen, the former University of Calgary Dino.
He was the only one that really wasn't pointing. He kind of knew.
Yeah.
Second and five. Key down here. Big rush. Adams flushed and crushed and hit hard. And the ball is loose. Ottawa say they have it. And Vernon Adams on the turf. Looks like he's in some pain here. Get him out from under the pile. Still no signal. Slow to get up, but looks like he's okay.
Vernon Adams Jr.
They are saying it is Montreal ball. It'll be third down, third and about five, so they'll bring the kick team out. Let's take a look at this hit.
Uh, Adams wrapped up and really not in a position to be able to defend himself or brace himself as J.R. Tavai comes from the backside.
And there is a whistle. Is there something from the sky that they might have notified Foxcroft on a potential shot to the head? So they're looking at that again. That can come from the eye in the sky. There is no challenge flag. They're looking at it here. Vernon Adams is looking at it, eyes wide. What do you think? And he was in a very vulnerable position.
Yeah, you know, it would be a legitimate call based on the standard that has been set.
Yeah. Looks like they are lining up, though. So, likely looked at it. Decided not to call it. Beatty from the 30. Make this a one-point ball game. What an interesting series. Touchdown taken away. The Owls still score. Close one here tonight on Friday Night Football in Montreal. One-point ball game, 21-20 Ottawa now. You saw Vernon Adams take that shot in sitting position. He got it to the head. There was no call on the play. There was no challenge on the play. But Antonio Pipkin, who hasn't played since game one, left with an ankle injury, lost the starting job to Vernon Adams, has been injured, was warming up with Matthew Schultz.
Eye on that situation, but right now all eyes on number 17 in red and black.
Devontae Dedmon. Boris Beatty puts it through the end zone, and Dedmon will give up the point to tie the game. And he leads the CFL in kickoffs. I don't know if I've ever seen that. It's like a Brad Marchand play, that Boris Beatty. Well, again, well, this rivalry has been renewed. Really never had a chance to get kick-started.
You haven't sort of had both franchises be strong, be competitive.
Yeah, since the Rough Rider days, probably. Well, it's back now, and it's heated. And it's tied tonight, midway through the third quarter. Dragging down John Crockett is John Bowman. The ageless wonder. Another plunder here. He's 7 years old.
Ageless is right when it comes to John Bowman from his familiar defensive end spot. One of the all-time sacks leaders in the Canadian Football League. Keep an eye on Dominique Davis on that boot.
Three-man rush, second and 13. Here comes Bowman, chasing down Davis, chasing him down, and it's up for grabs, it's picked off. That's number two on the night.
And credit Mr. Bowman with the hurry.
John Bowman rushed. Dominique Davis, another pick for Ciante Evans. The ninth interception thrown by Dominique Davis. Tied for most in the CFL. This one hit about five pairs of hands and ended up in Ciante Evans' mitts. Tie game, another turnover on a wild Friday Night Football game.
Got seven good reasons that you give her a call. It all worked out when you walked out. true.
Count the Ways, the new single from Jade Eagleson. Listen on Apple Music.
So indeed, Vernon Adams is on the sideline after that last hit. Turnover by the Redblacks. Antonio Pipkin returns to quarterback for the Owls since game one of the season. Flag down. Pipkin started the season, given the job.
Procedure, Montreal number 50. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
Struggled in the opener. Left the game with an ankle injury. Hasn't played since. Now he's back in, forced in tonight. What appears to be an injury to Vernon Adams.
Well, these two guys battled for the starting position through training camp. Once again, Pipkin.
Slant, quick hitter, far side.
Pipkin earned the job, starting job coming out of training camp. You know, there are some similarities certainly between the skill sets of Pipkin and Adams, particularly in terms of mobility. Pipkin is a powerful runner. I've suggested before, it reminds me a little bit of Michael Bishop when he kind of attacks the edge on the sprint out.
And his arm does too.
Yeah.
He has got a wicked arm. Throwing this one out, lunging out. Malcolm Carter saying in.
Yeah, bobbled this one as he hit the ground.
And he's not arguing. So, two and out after that turnover. No damage done.
Yeah, this would have been a big first down getting into Ottawa territory for the Alouettes. That little bobble. You could see the ball took a bit of a roll on the turf as he slid forward.
Two returners back, both guarding the corners.
Yep. Want to catch the ball rather than letting him get it bounced out for field position.
Man of the night. Here he goes again. Straight arm, and Devontae Dedman continues to add to his numbers tonight. Moving closer to what could be a CFL record in yardage return. Another 29 added there.
And that'll move him within 34 of the team record set by Deontay Spencer at 363.
On a time in Hollywood.
Dominic Davis turns to the huddle. Tie ball game, 5 minutes to go, third quarter. And like last night in Regina and in Toronto, two teams that are going at it could come down to the wire, as we saw last night. Davis started the season with two wins, but last two games, 0-2. Jonathan Jennings also came in. Jennings a spectator tonight, helping out with the play calls on the sideline.
Yeah, former BC Lion. Had some struggles in his two starts. Still kind of finding his way with his new team.
I tell you, Vernon Adams is still in the Montreal locker room and trying to get a report after taking that hit from J.R. Tavai. A call on the play. And a very quick hitter. Patrick Levels comes up to his last name. Caleb Hawley dusted. His first catch.
Second and long. Now, once again, Levels. Great job fighting off the block of Noel Thomas to come up and make a play. But, you know, they injected new life into this defense with what they did in free agency in the offseason. Levels, Ciante Evans.
Fumble. Still loose. And Enoch Mwamba has it. Now, Mwamba has the ball. Was Davis down? Looks like the Redblacks are retreating to their bench, and another turnover.
And I'd like to take another look at this, because you would have thought that Dominique Davis was down.
No whistle. but they'll review because it is a turnover. That's the call on the field.
We'll see. This time the snap got back. He just mishandled it. Looked like he had it, but maybe because we can't see on the other side, he didn't clearly didn't have solid possession of it. There doesn't seem to be much of an argument from the Ottawa sideline. Yeah, you can see it's down around his waist. He doesn't have it in his hands. Antonio Simmons in there fighting for the ball, I think, popped it loose.
Yeah, he did. And Enoch Mwamba has the recovery. Score tonight on turnovers. Four induced by the Alouettes D. One for Ottawa. Points off turnovers, the most important. 10-7, Montreal. Plus three on turnovers and points. Plus three on turnovers. Pipkins in trouble. Now scampers out. Has to throw it, maybe. No, he's going down. He does throw it. And completes it. All right. What's next?
I think he's just looking for a throwaway to try and get it in the direction of a receiver. I mean, he was horizontal when he threw this football.
Yep, the circus must be in town tonight, folks. We've seen it all.
Yeah, Pipkin, a big, strong guy, and that's part of his escapability in the pocket. You can see he's totally falling back. He's trying to throw it away to avoid the sack.
It would have been better had he thrown it away. They lost a ton of yardage.
Or B.J. Cunningham had just batted it down.
Batted it down. Second and 16. They're in field goal range for sure. Pipkin stands in. And again, here is a guy who's probably shaking off some rust, too. Yeah. He has not played since opening week and has been on the shelf. So now Beatty will come out and try to regain the lead for the Alouettes. This field goal will be from the 45-yard line.
By the way, Devontae Dedmon's in the end zone to return this, should he happen to miss.
Of course he is. Matthew Schultz to supply the hold. Long snapper is Martin Bedard. Beatty, no miss here. Alouettes back in front by three. Slugfest continues. Go at it, 40.
Discovery's iconic summer event is back. Bite after bite, it's a jaw-inspiring lineup of all things shark. Don't miss the last two nights of Shark Week. 8 o'clock Eastern, only on Discovery.
I like Shark Week. I don't like sharks.
What do you have against sharks?
Wouldn't want to meet one. And backwards goes Crockett.
It was like they were passing him back down the line.
Like sharks.
Feeding frenzy for the Alouette defensive line right now.
Defenses are really ratcheting it up now here in this second half with 2 minutes plus to go before fourth quarter time.
Antonio Simmons, quick swim move off the line. Basically untouched and into the backfield.
Ottawa second down conversion. 4 for 11. Crossing pattern, levels again and on the play. Dominic Rhymes. Flag down, way back. Two flags down. And Ryan Brown saying it's against the Redblacks. Was it a hold?
I'm not convinced of the hold. I thought it might have been a roughing the passer.
Major foul.
It is.
Unnecessary roughness. Ottawa, number 58. 15-yard penalty.
And a first down.
Third down.
Third down, a 15-yarder.
So maybe in response, we'll see what Jason Lauzon-Segan did in response to a hit delivered on his quarterback.
Third quarter dominated by the D. No one able to really capitalize on the mistakes. Beatty got 3 points off that last turnover. Owls have the lead. Shakir Ryan. Little jitterbug here. He picks up a couple yards. Special teams tighten the screws as well.
Yeah, Brendan DeLander's a special teams demon. And the University of Ottawa star. Ottawa native out of Sir Wilfrid Laurier High School.
Still no update on Vernon Adams Jr. You just hope for that young quarterback, especially with the way he had been playing and the success he had brought the Owls. Now, it looks like this is Antonio Pipkin's game to close. William Standback, you know, we call it the year of the special teams, the year of the return. It's been the year of starting quarterbacks getting hurt, but also the year of backup quarterbacks coming to the fore.
Stepping up.
And the theme being, if you're a team in this league, you better have somebody behind number one ready to go.
Yeah, and there's no question of that. And I, you know, I look ahead to next year where CFL teams will only, roster rules will only allow them to have two quarterbacks on the active roster.
Pipkin sidearm. Bullet to Malcolm Carter's second catch.
And it makes me a little bit nervous.
Yeah, I think.
You know, it's, you know, we may not get within a game to the number three guy all that often. But when you talk about a league in which quarterbacks are throwing the ball 35, 40 times a game, sometimes running with the football as CFL quarterbacks do, the risk for injury is significant for those guys under center. You want to have some depth. You want to have some guys that are prepared to play.
Off the edge, Pipkin bounces off, goes gunning, and completes the pass, and it is dropped. Wynicke had it.
Yeah, this is...
Did you see this edge rush here?
Well, Corey Tindall times up the blitz.
And Pipkin stayed on his feet and almost delivered an incredible strike. That is three quarters. We've had a lot of unpredictability here tonight. Some crazy stuff. Lots of drama. Highlight reel gathers again. We'll gather again in a couple moments for the fourth quarter, going down to the wire. Friday Night Football.
On iHeartRadio.
Vernon Adams started this game for the Owls tonight. Two rushing touchdowns in it, trying to get a fourth straight win for his team. This happened in the third quarter. J.R. Tavai from behind. Not sure about the malicious intent at all. Tavai trying to make a football play, but it was a real tough hit. And a hit that right now has knocked Vernon Adams Jr. out of the game and into the locker room.
Yeah, and if you saw when Adams went down to the turf after taking that hit, he looked like he immediately grabbed his head. Mm-hmm. And so definitely concerned. Obviously, as you said, I don't think that J.R. Tavai is guilty of targeting per se. You're coming in at full speed and a guy is getting pulled down at full speed. It's hard to aim where you're going to put your hit. He ends up kind of drilling Vernon Adams in the back of the head, and the Alouette quarterback is out of this game.
Antonio Pipkin's game. First time he's at the helm since game one when he got knocked out by the Edmonton Eskimos with an ankle injury. Second down and 10 for Pipkin. Getting some rhythm here and a couple of drops he's had. Wynicke previously, as we went to break, as we start the fourth quarter, and something you don't see every day from Eugene Lewis, should have had that one. So now it's third down, would be at a long field goal, would be about a 51-yarder, but I think Beatty's, no, they're going to kick a field goal here. It's 51.
And that is the fourth, whether you want to say should have been catch or almost catch of this second half.
So this is a 51-yarder. Actually, they're stretching it out now. It's to 53. This would match his career long. It's the shade under 53. And you know who's in the end zone. Should he miss? This kick is wide. And there is Dedmon. Devontae Dedmon bursting outside. Flag down. Dedmon under the 30. Cuts back near the 40 and adding to his real estate tonight. But we'll see if those yards count as there was a flag down on the return. Every time this guy touches the ball, something good happens.
For Ottawa.
After the missed field goal, during the return, holding Ottawa number 35. It's a 10-yard penalty. That's against Ottawa. 10-yard penalty, Ottawa first down.
Beatty with the miss.
A few more return yards for Dedmon. You know, it's seems like a small little thing when you look at roster moves that teams make with backup players over the course of the week. But one guy that got shuffled off the roster for Montreal this week is backup linebacker Jean-Gabriel Poulin.
This ball is going all the way back to the 1 yard line, just beyond the 1 yard line. So significant early fourth quarter series here for Dominic Davis. Dedmon stays in to play receiver. This was his primary spot at William & Mary. Davis is going to roll now. And throw now. Now, a critical second down. They don't get it. They're likely giving up two.
Tough spot.
And it's unlike last week. Yeah, and you would punt it out.
Situation.
But if they don't get it here, you're likely giving up two. Especially with Shakir Ryan back. Ottawa has not done well on first down in this second half. They need a second down conversion. They put it in the hands of Clackett. Enoch Mwamba. Big stop.
Enoch Mwamba had a time in his career where he battled some injuries, bounced around a little bit before landing in Montreal last year. A lot of people maybe weren't sure how much he had left. I think he's played some of his best football the last 2 years. It's been outstanding.
Former first round pick. First overall. St. FX. Richie Leone, he's got a big foot, leading punter in the Canadian Football League. Will he launch? Will he give up two? He's launching. It's a line drive kick to Ryan. And instant field position for Antonio Pipkin and the Owls. And you wonder if the decision also was made based on the fact that no offense is really doing anything right now.
Yeah, I think people may immediately look and think that Rick Campbell is thinking about last week and, you know, should I have or should I not have. Rick Campbell doesn't think that way. He's coached long enough in this league that he's making these decisions on an individual basis and what the flow of this game is.
Well, his defense has stepped up. Led by Ellis, Claussen, Wakefield, and Tavai, that front four. Coming at Pipkin once more. First and 10, Pipkin with time. Far side, hanging on is Lewis this time with a first down.
And the Alouettes go to a max protection scheme. Make sure they get things blocked up. One receiver out to the wide side is Lewis. You had eight guys stay in that protection scheme to get things blocked up and ensure Antonio Pipkin wasn't going to be pressured.
Showing house here. They're bringing it, but they came early, it looked like. Trying to go over the top. And there was a flag. Looked like the Redblacks on that blitz came off that edge awfully early.
Well, we see them trying to time up their blitzes.
Ottawa, five-yard penalty. Repeat, first down.
First and five. More manageable.
This time it's your Will linebacker, Avery Williams, second man in there.
Campbell has not seen his team lose five in a row since the expansion season back in 2014. They lost their final five. Things turned around in a big way in Ottawa. Turn and fire. And Quan Bray down inside the 10. Another big play from Bray.
And I like the adjustments being made here. You see a little bit of play action. They've been in double tight for this possession. And with stand back there, you get sucked in by that run fake. And then a quick hitter.
Close to being a horse caller on that play, but no call. So first and goal. 4 minutes gone in the fourth. Blitz again. Pitch out, shovel pass. Bray chased down. Anthony Chaffee.
Yeah, well defended by Anthony Chaffee. Nickel linebacker for the Redblacks. Great pursuit of essentially what they're trying to do is shake him. You see Chaffee back here in the backfield. He's going to end up tracking Bray across the formation. Does a great job not getting caught up. Doesn't lose him behind the line, doesn't get caught up in the traffic of other people working across the formation. Steps up to make the play.
Pads are popping here tonight. We've had some heavy hitting. Another key play here for the Ottawa D. Second and goal. Three-man rush. Pipkin. End zone. And so once again, it's going to be up to Bo Beatty. This time much shorter.
That woman looked particularly upset about the incompletion.
It's been a roller coaster of emotion for these fans here tonight.
Just an incomplete pass, ma'am.
Well, the key one. So now Beatty, after missing from 53, this one from inside the 20. Lots of time left still. Owls. Now move ahead by six, 27-21. Bahari Jones seeking a fourth straight win for the Owls, who started the season with two losses. But as you know, anything can happen on Friday Night Football, and tonight it has.
On Discovery.
Got a show for y'all tonight, you heard me?
I'm coming, Trev! I'm coming!
Coach, he's made me a better player.
I'm nice.
Mic'd up players, behind the scenes action. CFL Wired returns Tuesday, bringing you exclusive access to the latest CFL football highlights, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. You're mic'd up tonight. Boy, there'd be a lot of grunting and groaning going on there, but some big hits, big plays. Two of them supplied by Devontae Dedmon. May not be done here tonight. Trying to follow a few blocks. Goes right into traffic. Picks his way up near the 30-yard line. So the Redblacks have to play comeback again. Down six.
Well, I started to talk earlier about a little roster shuffle that saw a backup linebacker and special teams demon Jean-Gabriel Poulin bumped to the practice roster this week, and you wonder a little bit as you have a bit of a tough night with your cover units if you might want to get another good tackler back on the roster.
Dedmon on the sideline after that return. Dominic Davis trying to lead his team to victory. man rush, fires, quick hitter, Julian Faioli-Godino. Always loves coming back to play here from this province, born in Costa Rica actually, but of course grew up playing as a star at Laval University outside Quebec City.
Faioli-Godino, originally a Toronto Argonaut draft pick.
Davis looking one way then the other. There's the first down on second and four. Threading the needle. Second first down of the second half. Dominic Rimes catching. Taylor Loeffler hitting. You know how they have the heat index in the summer? We're going to have the hit index. There are some heavy hitters in this game tonight.
There certainly are.
Loeffler to Aki. Levels. Wamba. Uh-oh. Davis steps up. Goes bombing. And what a defensive play.
Yeah, tremendous timing.
Oh, my goodness. Greg Reed at the last moment took away one of the biggest plays of the night.
Greg Reed enjoying a tremendous season here, but much concern.
There is a player down here, and knees are down too. Two players are down, as a matter of fact. And we will go to break and come back here in Montreal with the Owls up 27-21 and injuries on the field.
Hotel Trivago.
Well, a couple of injuries on this play. Keep an eye on the matchup. Antonio Simmons, Jason Lauzon-Séguin. They're the two injured players. What you're going to see happen. Simmons beats him clean around the edge. John Bowman comes around the other edge. The two defensive ends collide. It looked like Lauzon-Séguin, after he kind of whiffed on the block and went down awkwardly. Not sure whether it's a wrist or shoulder. Keep an eye on the number two receiver going down just inside the numbers here. And Greg Reed, the halfback, picks him up. Beautifully timed jump.
Taking it away from Caleb Hawley. And there's another big completion for Dominic Davis. Back to Dominic Rimes. The Dominiques combined again. Big first down into Montreal territory.
Well, they were looking for a nickname for this quarterback receiver battery earlier in the year after a big game. I kind of like the Legion of Dom.
Legion
suggestion.
Of Dom, I like. The Domination. Right now they're trying to play comeback. Davis to Noel Thomas. In a few games last year before getting injured, back on the roster, back contributing with the Red Blacks, and of course they needed some receivers in the offseason with Greg Ellingson going west. Deontay Spencer off the roster. First and 10 from the 41, midway through the fourth. Last team with the ball tonight might win this thing. Here comes a blitz off the edge. Crockett. Fabian Foot swallows him up.
Fabian Foot on the tackle. Using his second down.
Well, with Jason Lauzon-Séguin going down, by the way. Evan Johnson, University of Saskatchewan product. Go to Campbell Collegiate in Regina. He makes a shift from left guard to right tackle. Alex Fontana, Ottawa's first round pick this year, comes in at guard.
Davis again. Oh, just missing Sinopoli on second down. It'll be third down. Got to go for the points here. They'll bring out Lewis Ward. His first field goal attempt of the night. This is going to come inside the 50-yard line. Around the 47. Lewis Ward. What has he done? Well, 64 in a row. All-time pro football record. 16 of 16 on the season. Spot this. It looks like the kick will come from the 46. Trying to make it 65. Kick is up and it is good, of course.
Of course.
Can't miss, kid. Just keeps hitting. 65 in a row. 22 in a row. 40 plus and beyond. Key, though, his team within three. And he likely might be called upon again tonight on Friday Night Football. Back in Montreal, the Hlinka Gretzky Cup comes your way Monday as the world's elite 2020 NHL prospects go head-to-head. Best-to-best showdown, Dwayne Ford. Finland, Team Canada. 9:30 a.m. Eastern, 6:30 a.m. Pacific, only on TSN. Lights are on in Montreal tonight. Friday night lights. Good one here cooking. Antonio Pipkin and his offense back with the ball. Little read option. Pipkin scrambling now and throws it away. A lot on the line here tonight. Two teams coming in going in opposite directions. One trying to carry some momentum after a bye. The other trying to get some momentum back.
Well, and certainly it's been a great battle. Again, speaks to how tight things are in the Canadian Football League in terms of competition, just competitive level, competitive balance between teams.
And even the two teams that raced out to great records now coming back to the pack a little bit. Winnipeg in the West, Hamilton in the East. Both losing last night, now 5-2 records. Pipkin. Oh, big toss and dropped. Incomplete, looking for Cunningham. And another huge defensive stand by the Ottawa Redblacks. We'll bring the punt team out.
BJ Cunningham, two receiver just under the numbers in your picture. Getting into the danger zone there. Fernandez, the middle linebacker, just waiting for him.
Another one of those hard hitters. Guy who's made the biggest impact tonight on special teams. 3 yards away from the Ottawa record, likely on this return. Devontae Dedmon, although this is off the side of the foot. Here comes Dedmon. Got the three, just gets the three. Big night for him. Ottawa has the ball, down three. Let's go down to John Liu with an important update on Vernon Adams.
Well, thank you, guys. And an Alouettes official has confirmed that Vernon Adams is indeed undergoing concussion protocol in the Alouettes dressing room. The slight delay that's followed the sequence during which Adams Jr. was injured was indeed the concussion spotter on duty, flagging down, buzzing the Alouettes at their sidelines that Adams Jr. should be removed from the game, which in fact he has. He's now been in the dressing room for roughly a full quarter now, guys, and so I'd say that return is doubtful, extremely doubtful at this point.
5:23 to go. Really tough news for the Alouettes to swallow with Vernon playing so well. Hard hit. Davis, read option, gives it off to Crockett. Barrels. First down play establishes the ground. They could probably go to the ground again here. Second and short.
Yeah, put themselves in a good position with that first down production. Little misdirection behind the line of scrimmage. A couple fake handoffs to receivers in motion, trying to create some space. Open up some gaps for John Crockett between the tackles.
Second down and two. Percival Molson Stadium. Pumps up the volume. Read option, Davis. That had to be caught Another drop, Noel Thomas. It's third down and two. Now you have to punt the ball away in this field position. And that was so catchable. Another drop here.
Yeah, both quarterbacks, both teams' quarterbacks have experienced some of this with the drops.
Fourth drop now for the Redblacks. See if that comes back to hurt them. It'll be up to Pipkin to close this out. Kills the clock. Shakir Ryan. Downfield quickly on the Redblacks. Shakir down the sideline. Knocked out of bounds. And wanted a call. And there was a flag that came down. You can add 15 after that extra hit out of bounds by Nigel Romick. This does not help the Red Blacks' cause.
Unnecessary roughness, Ottawa number 47. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Take another look at the tail end. This one.
Just that little extra tug on these sidelines. Very cramped confines.
And, you know, you get the speed guy and you're worried that he's going to beat you around the corner, but both players were pretty much standing on the white stripe before the tackle was initiated.
I saw Bob Dice's reaction. He said, really? Now it's up to Pipkin to let this clock bleed a little. And he comes up throwing. And it's... Oh, should have been picked. There have been so many balls that have been dropped tonight. DeAndre Montgomery, that was easy picking.
Missed opportunity.
That might have absolutely changed this ball game. He had running room, too.
And Montgomery, it's like a center fielder getting a jump on this one. Ball pops up in the air. I think he was maybe looking at where he was going to run with it. As receivers are occasionally guilty of running before they catch it.
For a game with so many outstanding highlights tonight, grabs and special teams plays, there have been a few not so great highlights tonight.
Not so pretty moments.
No. Could become costly for both sides. Montreal took a timeout. Second down. Lucky they didn't have that picked off. Pipkin stands in. Gray hit right at the first down marker. See what the spot is. It might be third and inches here, maybe a half foot.
Yeah, to eyeball it. Definitely less than a yard.
So third down. Keep in mind, Antonio Pipkin has a good running guy. He's not been behind center since week one. So he'll handle the rock here on third down. And they'll rush to that line. We saw that with Vernon Adams. And they will wait on this play because the 3-minute warning is now upon us. This one's still up in the air, up for grabs. As was this ball, which could have changed things considerably for the Red Blacks. No. 3-minute warning from Montreal. Friday Night Football. Kahari Jones, Rick Campbell. Chess match continues here tonight. Violent chess match.
Is Kahari Jones dancing?
He's always dancing. And there's Vernon Adams back. Apparently underwent concussion protocol. Here is a key play. Third down and inches. When Adams was in, these were not gimmies by any stretch. Here's Pipkin behind center. And now he's waiting. And he goes forward and gets it. A little more push this time. Clock comes down to 2:45 as Montreal tries to preserve a fourth straight win, move within a game of the division-leading Hamilton Tiger Cats. But that is really tough news for the Alouettes, in particular Vernon Adams. It has not been an easy ride for this guy since he came north of the border.
Yeah, a guy who's really, you know, a guy who is sort of pegged to be an instant star in the Canadian Football League when there is very rarely such a thing at the quarterback position in this league. And as you said, a rather circuitous journey to finding success after a couple years in Montreal, then off to Saskatchewan, then Hamilton, and finally back to Montreal before really getting a chance to start a string of games. And even that took an injury to Antonio Pipkin to open the door.
The great irony of it all is in Hamilton was the third guy in the Johnny Manziel drama that was there. Manziel comes to Montreal. Adams eventually comes here, takes over the job after Pipkin went down. You still following along at home? Then Pipkin comes back tonight after Adams goes down. And that 6-2 record, look what everybody else has done in the quarterback carousel that has been the Montreal Alouettes.
Yeah, I think it speaks volumes. You know, and even looking ahead with the guys they have here, in particular Adams and Pipkin. Pipkin with a couple of wins last season in a year where wins were few and far between. They have to feel pretty good about those guys on their depth chart. Matthew Schiltz, the number three man.
Just released Brandon Bridge. Pipkin coming back. So Bridge is available. He's out there. Corey Tindall limping gingerly to the sideline. And should Montreal hang on for victory tonight, Adams would get the win as he was the starter. You heard Matt Dunnigan say before the game it would be the first time, if they get the win, the Owls have had a quarterback lead them to fourth straight wins since Jonathan Crompton. Only two other quarterbacks have ever done that. Tracy Hamm and, of course, the legend Anthony Calvillo. But there's still a lot of time left here. 2:35. First and 10. I wonder if they'll keep it a little more conservative after having a near miss on that pick. And they'll keep it on the ground for Standback. So probably the biggest play right now for this defensive unit, Noel Thorpe and the Ottawa Redblacks. Stop here. They get the ball back. With Antonio Pipkin in. On second down, the Owls are only 1-for-7 on second down. Second and 8.
Watch for them to try and time the blitz.
Pipkin looks, pumps, looks again, down he goes. And a huge play by the Ottawa Redblacks. Their defense has come to play here since that first quarter. Avery Ellis, key sack. And now the Redblacks will get the ball back. And Devontae Dedmon will go back as well.
Yeah, all kinds of pressure here from the Ottawa Redblacks. Keep an eye. Avery Ellis is the guy who eventually gets there, coming from the backside as Pipkin moves to his left. But Ettore Latanzio in Pipkin's face, getting a hand up, forcing him to pull it back down as he tried to set up to throw. That allowed time for Ellis to get around the horn and make a play.
This is what you love about the CFL and how the points all work out. Think about that single point on the kickoff, how important that is now, earlier by Boris Beattie. That point gives him a three-point cushion right now. Devontae Dedmon, just heard from the special teams unit, coaching staff, has already scored 2 touchdowns on returns tonight. No one in CFL history has scored 3.
Yeah, he's really slumping in the second half, though.
Yes, he is. And how important is this kick right now from Boris Beattie? And now Kahari Jones is looking to use this challenge flag. Looks like. Curious that he has it out of his pocket. Threw it on the ground, then Did he pick it up? We'll know in a moment.
Montreal is challenging that their receiver number 87 had defensive pass interference committed against him. We'll review the play.
So Kahari Jones, looking to use his flag, and it might be a good challenge.
Yeah, looking for a reprieve. You know, remember we talked, Eugene Lewis is at the top of your screen, first receiver.
Have to give them 5 yards, remember, before a jam. Looks like about 3.5, almost 4.
We may have a case here. But, you know, remember we discussed earlier when on the play where Vernon Adams got hurt on the hit from J.R. Tavaia, whether they should be challenging to look for roughing play there. But you want to save it until a key time, maybe.
Here's Dave Foxcroft. Clarify what's going on down there.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Montreal will lose their final timeout.
Well, you have that challenge flag in your pocket the entire game, though. You kind of save it for a moment that you might need it. So now two returners back, and again, protecting those corners, those coffin corners. Devontae Dedmon. Ottawa franchise record now tonight in kickoff return and kick return yards, breaking the record. Deontay Spencer, second most in CFL history tonight. Baiting, towering kick. Muffed. Dedmon does well to hang on. Hangs on, Devontae Dedmon. Now a long field for Dominic Davis and the REDBLACKS.
Yeah, a place where they really could have used a big one to put them in position. Not that Dedmon hasn't done more than his share tonight, but tough break there for the Ottawa REDBLACKS return men.
Big play to hang on to the football. So now, a minute 51 to go. Trying to get it in field goal position at best. There's Caleb Hawley. Hawley ducks one and another up near the 40, and quickly, only 9 seconds taken off the clock. They march closer to field goal range. And you know, Lewis Ward has been automatic for 2 seasons now.
A nice job on the cut block by John Crockett as the cut forces the defender, Bo Lacumbo, to drop his hands, get his arms out of the pass lane.
Bill Thomas snares one close to a first down. Looks like they're going to mark it right at the marker, and they will move the chains, or will they? Yes, they will. Another 10-second play.
Lewis Ward warming up on the sidelines for a potential game-tying field goal.
Enoch Mwamba shows blitz. Davis chucking again. Hawley takes a hit. Picked up about 8. Lots of time here. REDBLACKS were just trying to get in field goal position, but they got a chance to take this to the house and win this game here on this drive.
And for some of the drops we've seen tonight, you see Caleb Hawley, as soon as he came down, he knows contact's coming, got 2 hands on that ball immediately.
Second and 2. Crockett has 2. A little bit more. First down again at the 45 now. If you don't get any further, it's about a 52-yard field goal. Minute 2 to go. That can be an eternity in the Canadian Football League.
A very effective job done by the Ottawa offense to this point on this drive.
Seem to be better when they're in no huddle and lots of rhythm. Hawley again. Hawley's been quiet all night until this fourth quarter. Clock's at 47. It'll be 2nd and 3. Dominic Davis, Dwayne, 4 of 4 on this drive. Lewis warms. Would be a 45-yarder from here. Clock it again, up the middle.
Great cut.
Great play, down to 37. So now offensively? Do you play it a little conservatively? Or do you go for the end zone, take a couple of shots, and go for the win? Forget the tie. Gotta think win here. 34 seconds. Davis going for the win. End zone. Julian Fioli-Gattino can't get it. Tommy Campbell. Huge defensive play.
Yeah, Campbell in good position. Running with the Ottawa receiver.
Hometown boy almost spoiled the party.
And you talk about going for the win or playing conservative. You said go for the win. If you don't get there, you can settle for the tie.
Go to overtime. Yeah. You got to be careful with this clock, though. Second and 10. Try to get a first down here. Little Thomas won't. And that will bring out Lewis Ward. It'll be third down. And overtime lurks. Will the streak continue? 65 in a row for one of the smallest players in the league, one of the tiniest kickers in the history of the game, who's got a huge leg and has been clutch.
They picked up about 6 yards on that last play. You kind of weigh that against trying to center up the ball for the field goal attempt as they're kicking now from the hash.
So, 29 yards from OT. Lewis Ward, the streak continues. 66 in a row. Has not missed since his first game as a rookie kicker last year. Last year's Rookie of the Year, Special Teams Player of the Year. Automatic. And we're 2 seconds away. And it's also all about that, the battery. People don't talk much about the holder, his buddy Richie Leone. And you know, they're working with the new long snapper as well, last couple of weeks.
Yeah, Mike Benson. Former BC Lion. Coming in as Louis-Philippe Bohassav serves a suspension.
Mike, the longtime veteran holder, comes in, and now we're headed to overtime. Why not? That's the kind of game it's been.
It certainly has. You know, the most disappointing part of overtime, though, is there's no kickoff.
Yeah.
Devontae right. Dedmon and Shakir Ryan as well supplying much of the excitement tonight. No kickoffs, no punts.
Well, there's a field goal miss, though. Yeah. Go the other way. Well, there's still at least one kickoff left here. Shakir Ryan back. Then we'll go to the shootout. ...27-27, Friday Night Football. Now they're going to set up a block here, a few blocks for Shakir Ryan's going nowhere. We know where we're going. We're going to overtime. And we'll go to commercial and come back. Antonio Pipkin, Dominic Davis in a shootout here in overtime on TSN's Friday Night Football. Sometimes the most important play in overtime is this one, the coin flip.
Yeah, absolutely. Deciding who's going first. Generally considered an advantage to go second, so you know whether you need a touchdown or if you can settle for a field goal.
We'll play a maximum 2 mini games, 40. Have to go for a 2-point convert. That rule added the last couple of seasons. And whoever wins the mini game. Again, you just might have one minigame, depending on what happens.
Now, we talked with Ottawa and Calgary playing last week. Those two teams had played the only to tie games in the CFL since 2010.
Mm-hmm. Ottawa 2-3-2 overtime. They've played a few of them. We've had a few of those overtime
games. The coin for overtime. The league logo is heads. The team logo is tails. Ottawa, you're the visitors. What's your choice?
Heads.
Heads is the call. It's a tail. Montreal, you've won the toss. You can't defer. So you want to play defense? You want defense first. Okay, what end would you like the mini game to be played at? At this end. Okay, Ottawa will start the mini game at this end.
Now the advantage, obviously, to go second, see what you have to do, but we've seen a lot of overtimes where the team that goes first takes that first punch, has been able to win. This is our first overtime of the 2019 regular season. And the Ottawa Redblacks, Monte Dedman. The streak. Talking with Marcel Desjardins, the general manager of the Ottawa Redblacks. What a find this guy's been. Think about it. Ottawa GG kicker. Phenomenal U Sport kicker. Wasn't given a chance to make the team. CFL roster.
TD Place Stadium.
Security guard. So they go from the 35. Davis operates. Far side. Julian Faoli-Godino.
Sure tackle in space out there by Ryan Carter. Limit the damage.
It's always interesting, the play calling that goes on in OT as well. Some teams like to go take a big shot. Others like to nickel and dime. Bottom line is you got to get some points here. Got to put some points on the board if you're the team initiating. That looked like a first down. Noel Thomas, they'll mark it at the first down. Marker, just inside the 25. Dominic Davis seems to get more authoritative as this game goes on. One thing you can't do is turn it over on your first up. Julian Faoli-Godino didn't know where he was going there for a moment. Slant patterns to Sinopoli. You would think he would be the safety valve, particularly in this time, in overtime.
Yeah, a guy you want to lean on for sure. Caleb Hawley was big, though, in Ottawa's final drive to set up the tying field goal.
Mm-hmm. Second down and two. Crockett in the backfield. Dominic Davis, 8 for his last 9. Hands it off, Crockett. First down inside the 10. Now you really have to hold if you're Montreal's D.
Yeah, Ottawa has come out here kind of fired up after finishing the game with some momentum. There's nothing but a touchdown on their minds right now.
First team up here in the shootout in overtime tonight. Crockett. Hit hard, knocked down, throwing down. Big down here. Enoch Mwamba, another hit tonight.
Yeah, good matchup here. Mwamba, number 10. Shuffling, tracking the running back. Squares up and makes that form tackle.
Second and goal. Davis at the goal line. Sinopoli wanted a call. Incomplete. Crowd erupts. It's third down. Third and goal. That's Lewis Ward's time now.
It looked like there was a brief discussion over on that Ottawa sideline of whether to go all in and go for the touchdown there, but they send out the field goal team.
So now, chip shot for the lead. Chance to extend the streak to 67. Lewis Ward isn't even thinking about the streak. He's thinking about putting it right through the uprights. He does. Red Blacks score first. Now Montreal must match or do better. Well, this game is over. makes you wonder about Antonio Pipkin's mentality. A guy who's, again, shaking off rust, hasn't played since game one, now thrust right into the fire.
Yeah, I thought that the Alouettes did a nice job. You know, a couple series in particular where they seem to, in terms of formation and play call, do things to allow him to settle in a little bit. You know, going max protection, going with plays that he could get the ball out of his hands quickly. They're going to spread things out here. Their traditional five-receiver set.
Stand back in the backfield for blocking help. Pipkin, dump it off to stand back. Bad toss. Good news for Pipkin and the Owls is if they do stall, you're in instant field goal range in the shootout. But
yeah, again, the value of winning that coin toss and being the team that goes second on your first shot here.
Second and 10. Here in OT, got to get to the 25. Four-man rush. Pipkin. Crossing pattern. They're going to be short. Stand back. Fumbled. Game over. Whistle on the play. They will look at this before they celebrate. The Ottawa Redblacks may have just ended their losing streak. Was stand back down?
Well, if you call it a turnover on the field, it's being reviewed.
We'll know right here. Crossing pattern.
The previous play,
I'm not sure. I think it was a fumble.
I think so too.
DeAndre Montgomery with the football and likely the closer here. And the Alouettes, who had a six-point lead late.
Yeah,
that's a fumble.
Definitely out.
That's a fumble. That's game.
Fernandez had the strip, pulled that ball out of there.
That's the game. That's a win for the Ottawa Redblacks. Long time coming, losing four straight. Record goes to 3-4. Montreal will fall to 3-3. Really don't have to confirm anything now. This will be confirmed shortly. Dave Foxcroft will give us the confirmation here. Redblacks will head home, likely with a W, here tonight in Montreal.
After review, the ruling on the field stands. Fumble, recovered by Ottawa. The game is over.
Seventh straight road win here for the Redblacks in Montreal. Can't wait for November 1st. They'll be back at it again, and that will be the rubber match. Could mean a lot. The Alouettes, their three-game win streak ends. They lose the game in OT. They lose their quarterback in this game, and we'll be monitoring the progress of Vernon Adams before their next game against Saskatchewan next week. The Redblacks are off to Edmonton. Wild one tonight here. 40 here is our Nissan Titan player of the game.
Well, and he's the guy that scored all of Ottawa's first half points to keep them in the game as the offense took a while to get going. Kickoff return touchdown, punt return touchdown, an Ottawa franchise record for most kick return yards in a game, second most all-time with 377, our Nissan Titan player of the game.
Pinball Clements.
Devontae Dedmon, outstanding performance from him tonight.
And one of the highlights of the season, certainly that kick, they'll be talking about that return for a long time. Now the return of the Redblacks to the win column tonight. Lewis Ward keeps his streak going. And the Redblacks end their losing streak. Disappointing one for the Alouettes who lose Vernon Adams. Looked good early on for them. Tomorrow, live mic game. Eskimo Stamps, Battle of Alberta. Overtime, first one here tonight. Crazy game in Montreal. The Redblacks win 30-27. Coming up, SportsCenter. Good night, everybody. Here's Dutchie and Natasha.